हेलो गाइस, स्टैंडर्ड 6 चैप्टर नंबर 15 वाटर एंड इट्स इम्पोर्टेंस। सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट द स्टेट्स ऑफ वाटर, राइट? सो लेट्स रिवाइज इट व्हाट वी हैव लर्न्ड इन इट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर वर सो मेनी डेफिनेशंस लाइक फ्रीजिंग, व्हाट इज इवेपोरेशंस। Actually, there are main three types of the states of water: solid, liquid, and gas. So, how they were converted into each other? So, first of all, if we discuss about the solid form, the solid form is called as ice, liquid form is called as water, and gaseous form is called as water vapor, that means steam. So, when ice starts to melt, it is called as melting process, which is done by the 0 degree Celsius. When we apply heat to ice and the temperature of the ice surface will be 0 or more than 0 degree Celsius, it will be converted into liquid. This is called as melting process. Then after the melting process, when we apply heat to the water, so till 100 degree Celsius, this slowly start to boil, so this is called as boiling process. And by 100 degree, whatever temperature of the water will be, that will be boiling point, it is 100 degree, right? And above the 100, the water will start to convert itself into water vapor. This process is called as evaporation process. Then we have discussed about this diagram. So when this water vapor, which is present in atmosphere, it cools its temperature, right? So what happens? This water vapor will start to cool and will be converted into water. So this is called as condensation process. So when gas will be starts to convert into liquid, the process is called as condensation. And when this water starts to convert into solid, starts to convert into ice, this process is called as freezing process, which is done by 0 degree Celsius or less than 0 degree Celsius. So this was about the states of water. Now that was about transpiration. So what is the meaning of transpiration? We know that plants during the day, due to the stomata, there is loss of water. So kabhi hum plant ke niche baithe ho, we can feel coolness. Reason? Because there is loss of water through the stomata. So this process is called as transpiration process. Then today, what are we going to discuss? We will discuss about the cloud formation. Then next topic is about the water cycle. What happens in the 16th chapter? We have discussed about the air cycle, that means the oxygen cycle, how oxygen is useful and how it recycled in our environment, in our ecosystem. That we will discuss today. So guys, there is one question. Have you seen that water can be stored in atmosphere, can be stored in the clouds? Yes, let's discuss it. What happens? During the rainfall, there are too much amount of water is present in atmosphere. It can fill dams, rivers also. This much amount of water, this is too much water. How is possible this much amount of water can be stored in atmosphere or in clouds? Let's discuss it. So during the summer season, we know due to the temperature, as temperature increases, so surface of water temperature of the surface of water increases, and this water droplets starts to evaporate, and slowly slowly this water will be converted into water vapor and it will rise up. When it reaches at a certain height, it will be cooled down, because at height level there is no too much temperature, so it cools and again it starts to convert into water droplets. Same way, there are so many water bodies like river, ponds, lakes, sea, oceans. When we dry clothes, so water vapor, water will be converted into the water vapor, and transpiration process also, which is done in the plants. So what happens in the atmosphere when this all the water vapor reaches at a height and this all water vapor converted into water droplets? This water droplets which is present in atmosphere will attach to the particles, to the small particles of the dust in air, right? And when they all collect together and millions of water droplets join together and form a cloud, and when temperature of this cloud will be cooled down, then what happens? Cloud also condensate itself, cloud bhi thanda ho jata hai, and there will be rainfall on the surface of earth. So what happens in this process? I repeat, ki dheere dheere earth ki surface ke upar se, from the different water bodies, water starts to evaporate, water vapor rises at a height, it will be stored, it will be attached with the dust particles. Upar chadne ke baad thanda hota hai water droplets, and water droplets will be attached with the dust particles. They all will join together and form a cloud, and when cloud will condensate, cloud thanda ho jata hai, so millions of the water droplets join together and there will be rainfall on the surface of earth. This is called as the cloud formation. Now guys, let's discuss about the water cycle. So just look at this diagram. So guys, first of all, on our earth surface, what are the sources of water? So as a sources of water, there is river, lakes, ponds, seas, oceans, right? These all are the sources of water. So actually what happens, first we will start from these water bodies. So due to the sunlight, as temperature increases on the surface of earth, on the surface of water bodies, what happens? The water will be converted into, on the surface of this water temperature increases, so what happens? This water droplets will be converted into water vapor, right? So water will be evaporated from this rivers, lakes, through the loss of water through stomata in plants. So plant mein se bhi evaporation hota hai. Then dry clothes, wet clothes mein se water will be dry up. So by this way, all the water will be transferred in the atmosphere, right? it happens due to the sunlight. Now what happens? Second process, it is of condensation process. Just say so many water droplets are, sorry, so many, so much evaporation of water, and when this all the water vapor reaches at height, there is no water, sorry, there is no temperature. That means there is cool temperature over there. So this water vapor converts into the water droplets. These all are here, right? And this water droplets will be attached with the dust particles, and it forms clouds. And when in the cloud, this all the water droplets join together, cloud will be heavy. So when cloud will be heavy, then it starts to precipitate, that means rainfall, and again it falls on the surface of earth, right? And there will be river which starts to flow, ponds also filled with it. So this was the process of water cycle, right? Again I repeat, first of all, what happened? There are so many sources of water like rivers, lakes, ponds, seas, oceans, right? Due to the sunlight, this all the water which is on the surface of this body, this water starts to evaporate itself and reaches at a certain height, right? Then it will cool down, because at certain height there is less temperature, there is cool temperature, and it will stick with the dust particles and it forms clouds. When there will be too many water droplets joined together, millions of water droplets will join together, and it forms a cloud heavy. So due to the heavy cloud, heavy water will be, it starts to precipitate on the surface of earth, right? This is called as precipitation. But sometimes it also happens, if water is too much cool, it forms snow or hails, right? Here barf ke kare jisko hum bolte, snowfall. So aisa bhi hota at hilly areas, at Himachal Pradesh there might be snowfall or to hails also. This is called as barf ke kare jo hum yahan pe bolte. So by this way there will be precipitation by rain, snow or hails, right? And again this water will be, this rainfall will be, and runoff surface water will be by this water cycle. Now guys, let's see today's homework. Take out page number 252 of exercise. Take out two examples. Solve example number 2, 3, 4 and 5. Sorry, not 2, 3, 4, 5. Take out one word, right? Solve one word 2, 3, 4, 5. Then write down long question number 1 in fair notebook, right? And these things, one word will be written in textbook. ओके गाइस, थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे।